This feature is a must-have for any organization. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Organization Assets Library feature in SharePoint. Now, this is going to give benefits to SharePoint, Copilot, and it ties into the Brand Center as well. You'll get even benefits in your Office applications. So there's a lot of benefit here, and it's not hard to set up. I'm going to walk you through the entire thing. But there are some gotchas with this feature, and there's some things you need to be aware of. But don't worry, I've got you covered. I'll go through them all. Let's get into it. So what is the Organization Assets Library feature? It sounds like a kind of a generic name, right? And by the way, if we're just meeting, my name is Steve Corey. I'm a Microsoft MVP, and I make a ton of videos on SharePoint, Copilot, and integration between the two. But to get back to the point, Organization Asset Libraries are a place where you can store organization assets. Well, okay, let's just get rid of all those terms. Think Office templates. If you have corporate templates for PowerPoint, for Word, things like that, you could throw them into this library, and they're simply available in your Office applications. The desktop versions, the web versions, but it goes beyond Office applications. You could store images in here. You could store logos in here. And they'll be available in those applications. They'll be available in SharePoint. They'll also be available, and this one's new, it's also available in Copilot. Now, the original documentation doesn't even cover this just yet, but I've got a different document where it introduces a new parameter. We're going to be setting that up together. And I'm really excited. Let's just jump straight into this thing. Now, I'm on the Brand Center, and this is one of the things I wanted to point out. You could have multiple organization asset libraries, and you could have different types. Like there's the Office template one, there's image libraries. They're all made for different purposes, and different parts of M365 will pull from different ones, but they all have to be on the same site. So if you have two, three organization asset libraries or OALs, then they all have to be on the same site. And if you have the Brand Center, which I've covered that on my channel. If you have the Brand Center deploy, the SharePoint Brand Center, it has to be on the same site as your OALs. If you have the Brand Center deployed first, then the OALs will always have to be on the same site, because the Brand Center is also about bringing together all of those organization assets. They're all kind of designed to be the same type of thing. In this case, the Brand Center is designed to serve custom fonts to all your SharePoint sites, custom themes, things like that. So it's the same thing, but it's now it's serving the SharePoint sites. But because it's the same type of result, or the same type of goal that you're achieving, that's why everything has to be on the same site. So on the Brand Center, I'll go to Site Contents. And I've already got one library deployed. I've got an Office templates library that I've already enabled the OAL feature on. And I've already got one template in here. But we're going to start this from scratch. We'll get back to this one. But for now, let's just create a new library. I'll call this Image Assets. And I'll click on Create. So I've got a new blank library. Let's copy some test files in here and get some kind of files that we could use. All right, so I've got some image files. We're gonna have to come back to this, because there's some other things that we need to talk about when you're copying files into here. But more on that later. The next thing we need to do is hop into PowerShell, because that's how we enable the Organization Asset Libraries feature. For some reason, they just don't give us the option to do this through the Admin Center or anything. So that's fine. You only have to do this once per library. So I'm logged in to my tenant with PowerShell. Now I'm using the SharePoint Online Management Shell. This isn't PNP PowerShell. This is the official PowerShell module that comes from Microsoft. I've logged in on the admin tenant, and Now we're going to run a single command that's going to set this up. Now, the commands for this are linked down in the video description below. There's a couple of different ones. The main one that talks about organization asset libraries will tell us to run this command, add-spo-org-assets-library, and then we give it the library URL, and we give it the asset type. What type of asset is going to be stored in here, because you'll want your office templates stored separately from your image assets. There's a few other ones in here as well. If we were to get rid of that parameter and just hit the tab key, it'll cycle through some of the different organization asset libraries that can be created. Image document library, that's what we're going to be choosing. Office font library, the office template library, that's the one I already have set up. But we'll go back to the image document library. There's one new parameter though, and this is what is going to enable Copilot to see this library. So if we're using Copilot, we're trying to find a template, find a particular image, a company logo, it can find that stuff right through this parameter. It is Copilot searchable. And then we enable the feature by doing adding a dollar sign true in here. That's the Boolean true. That's why there's the dollar sign in there. But if we run this command, it'll confirm what we're doing. Now, this is warning us that it's creating a CDN on this library. Steve, what is a CDN? If you're not familiar with what a CDN is, it's called, it stands for Content Delivery Network. Really, it's just a fancy way of having a delivery system so that these files can be closer to your users, wherever they happen to be. These images will be copied behind the scenes in a secured way to different geographic regions so that when users, if their Copilot requests it, if PowerPoint requests it, it's not having to pull from a very far away place, wherever your data center happens to reside with these files. It can pull from a closer location, which just speeds up the process of the user accessing these particular assets. And by default, it is a private CDN. So it's not like it's publicly accessible or anything. It's still all secured with Entra ID, just like everything else in Microsoft 365. So it's just confirming we want to create a CDN with this, which that is a requirement. That's how the assets get distributed. So we have to allow this. And that's it. Document library has been added as an organization asset library. Notice it didn't create it. We had to create it first, but then we enabled the feature through this PowerShell. So we're done with PowerShell. Now let's go back over to the other library I have set up, because this may take up to 24 hours to actually propagate, because again, it's having to copy assets all over the place and stuff. So it takes a little bit, it takes a day ahead of time to set this thing up and let it do its thing before it will work. But I've already done that with the Office Templates library. So in here, I've got one PowerPoint template. Notice the extension is POTX, not PPTX. So you can't use a regular PowerPoint slide deck in here. It has to be, you have to actually save it as a template and then copy it here. And then it'll be available in PowerPoint. So let me open up PowerPoint. So I'm logged in and I'm on my tenant. If I click on the new button to create a new presentation, then we'll see an option over here. It's Steve Corey. That's just the name of my tenant. And we'll see that the template is available. If you've seen this type of feature already enabled in your organization, this is how it's happening. It's using that organization assets library feature. So now you know what's connecting those dots there between your company's templates and your applications. So if I click on this, then it creates a brand new presentation. Notice the name presentation one. That's how you know it's going to be a brand new one. And it's already got the template content copied in here, and I'm ready to create my new presentation. Now, just for a moment, let's go back to the image library we created, because there are some additional things you need to be aware of. Now, for Copilot to be able to find these assets, we're going to have to give it metadata. Copilot, while sure, AI does have some AI vision capabilities, it can kind of see an image. Copilot needs metadata. So these file names are terrible. And that was why I chose these. These are the sample, the default file names for those sample files. Copilot needs better file names. It needs metadata. It needs descriptions so that when someone is asking Copilot for a particular image, Copilot knows where that stuff is at. So when you're setting this up, you will want to add additional metadata columns, multiple line of text even, so that you can give images, all these assets, good descriptions. Remember, the better you describe these assets, the better the functionality will be through Copilot, the better the user experience will be, and the happier you'll be because you're going to not hear any as many complaints from people saying, where is this template? I can't ever find this thing. Where is this logo stored at? Things like that. There's some other things, though, that you have to keep in mind. With the image library, you only want the actual images in here. You don't want zip files. You don't want other things that are not images. And actually, there's a handful of file extensions that are allowed. But as long as you keep in mind that these do have to be images in this library, then you're not going to run the risk of Copilot trying to return a file that it thinks is an image because it is in an image library according to the OAL setting. But then users can't use. They'll get errors if they try and insert, you know, a zip file as an image in Word, for instance, or in SharePoint. So just make sure that the data is clean, the data is described well, and that you don't have duplicate images. That's another one. You don't want to have the same image in all these different resolutions, because what may happen is someone's trying to find an image and the system may return multiple resolutions of the same image. Well, if the image is wrong, that wasn't even the image they're looking for, then all those search results are useless to that person. They're just seeing five different resolutions of the same wrong image, as opposed to just having one resolution of the image in this library. And that way Copilot can return actually different images so that the user could find what they need to find quicker. So that's another one of the gotchas to be aware of. Don't worry about having multiple resolutions. Just have one and pick the best one. Along the lines of picking the best one, don't upload a gigantic file. Don't upload a 50 megabyte PNG, if that's even possible. It probably is. Don't upload those gigantic files because it'll just slow down the processing of that image when people try and insert that into a page or into a Word document or something like that. It slows it down. Make sure that these are reasonably sized images. Now, there's so many other features in SharePoint, like the Brand Center, that will complement this, this system will even empower. I've covered a lot of these types of features. So to get started with the next one, just click or tap the screen, and I'll see you over there.